Carrie Laboski, a soil fertility specialist with the University of Wisconsin-Madison and UW Extension. I'm here in an alfalfa field in Lafayette County in southern Wisconsin with Ted Bay, our extension agent in Lafayette and Grant County. And Ted asked me to come down here and look at this alfalfa. So Ted, do you want to talk to me about why we're here today?
Well, for a number of years here, we've had a concern among dairy producers about sulfur deficiency in their alfalfa. And what we want to talk about today is how do we confirm that, how can we test for it, and then how do we address the problem and try to correct these situations when we see them in the alfalfa. We're standing in an area of the field right now that's very dark green, looks very normal. We're at the bud to first flower stage of production and getting ready for first cutting on this particular field. And so in this area, everything looks normal, but as we pan across the field, we get to the areas that bring concern to the grower, and that's what we're out here today to try to address.
One of the challenges we have with assessing sulfur deficiency in alfalfa is that sometimes it's obvious and sometimes it's not so obvious. You can see on that hillside that there's patches where the alfalfa is noticeably more yellow. It might be a little bit shorter. And where it shows up really is in the contrast where you can see the areas where it's noticeably taller and a little bit greener. So if we look at some of the plants that we've pulled here, so I just want to note from those good and bad areas of this field, both sets of groups of plants were cut at the soil surface. And so the one here, these taller ones, though we're missing a lot of leaves here in the bottom, this is actually taller and noticeably greener. So now we're looking at a close-up of the leaves here on these two plants. And in this hand, on my right side, we're looking at the good area of the field. We can see a little bit darker color and bigger leaf. And then the left is where it was kind of that poor or bad area of the field. And you could really see a difference in the size of those leaves. The good area is a much bigger sized leaf. You can see a color difference as well, where the good area is a little bit darker green in color. And, you know, as we saw, the overall height of the plant was larger in the good looking area of the field.
Carrie, something that I think we should mention is that in a field like this, where we've seen areas of pretty vivid contrast between the normal alfalfa and areas that show that yellowing and potential deficiency in sulfur, What I'd like you to discuss for a moment is what do we do in fields where we're not sure about, you know, the sulfur levels and whether we have deficiency or not? How would you address that?
The best thing that we can do to confirm sulfur deficiency really is to take some tissue samples. The reason for that is, as you noted, that sometimes it's really obvious, and as we've had experience with it, we kind of know that it's sulfur deficiency where those large contrasts occur. But at other times it may be more subtle, and that's where taking tissue samples, sending them to a lab, and getting the results back will help you make a decision whether or not there's a need to treat with sulfur or if there's some other problem going on in the field. After a few days, you'll have your plant analysis report back, and you could look at the results and figure out what to do. So for this specific field, we're really looking for what's going on with sulfur. And if on that plant analysis test, what we're looking at in sulfur is a cutoff value of 0.25%. If you have less than 0.25% sulfur, that's considered deficient. And the lower the number is, the further away from 0.25%, the more deficient it is. I've seen fields that are down at around 0.15% and even a little bit lower on percent sulfur, and they are quite sulfur deficient. Some others might come in right at 0.24%. They're just a little bit sulfur deficient. Those might be the fields that are a little bit harder to tell that there's actually a problem out there because they're only a little bit deficient. Now, what we can expect if we apply sulfur to these fields that are deficient is we can expect yield responses. The lower the percent sulfur is in the tissue, the greater the yield response that we might see. So in some fields, I've seen a yield response of about 1 ton per acre over the rest of the growing season. So that would be if tissue samples were taken prior to first cutting, and then sulfur was applied immediately after that cutting. So the second, third, and fourth cut of the season would maybe have a yield increase of 1 ton per acre. Ted has seen in some of the plots that he's worked on down here in Lafayette and Grant County up to 2 or 2.5 ton yield increases. And if we think about the value, that's huge. Even if we just had a $100 per ton alfalfa with a 1 ton yield increase, that's $100. And the cost of a sulfur treatment is going to be maybe $25 per acre, maybe a little more, maybe a little less. So if you have less than 0.25% sulfur in the tissue, you want to apply some. A good rate would be anywhere from 20 to 25 pounds of actual S per acre. So not an enormous amount is needed. About 25 pounds is approximately crop removal of sulfur. So we don't necessarily need to want to build up because sulfur can move through the soil. So we don't necessarily want to apply a lot of excess because it may not be retained a whole lot. So when we think about forms of sulfur, this is really important. If you're experiencing problems in the field right now, you want to be using a sulfate form of sulfur. Those are soluble forms of sulfur. So products that you could use would be potassium sulfate, calcium sulfate, ammonium sulfate. They'd all be good sources. Now remember, with ammonium sulfate, alfalfa is fixing its own nitrogen. It doesn't necessarily need the nitrogen in that. It will take it up, so it won't become an environmental problem, but you might be paying for a nutrient you don't need. Often we find potassium deficiencies in many of our alfalfa fields. So while potassium sulfate may seem like it's an expensive source, if you actually need the sulfur and the potassium, it may actually be a fairly inexpensive source price per pound. The one source that you do not want to use if you're experiencing a problem in the field right now is elemental sulfur. Elemental sulfur is not used by the plant. We rely on the soil bacteria to convert the sulfur to sulfate, and then the plant takes up sulfate. And because we're relying on soil bacteria, it takes some time. And if you have a problem in the field today, you want to fix it as soon as possible. And that can be done with sulfate forms that if you apply right after first cut, by second cut, you won't see any differences in the field. So remember, 20 to 25 pounds per acre as a sulfate form of sulfur is the rates we want to work with. And it is a pretty economical application to make. Another point I'd like to make is when you're looking at the tissue and soil results from your good and bad areas of the field, we've often seen some interesting things happening with potassium. And with that, when we're in a bad area of the field, the soil test K levels might be optimum, or maybe even a little higher than that. And if we look at the soil test levels in the good area of the field, they are often less than what they are in the bad area of the field. And you say, well, what's going on there? What's happening is that where you have good alfalfa production because there's adequate sulfur, that crop is using a lot of potassium. And as the forage is removed, the potassium is removed, so the soil test decreases. Now, if we go into that poor area of the field, there's not enough sulfur for good crop growth, yields are lower, potassium removal is lower, so our soil test level doesn't change as much. So that's something to keep in mind when you see that, and that's why potassium sulfate might be a really good source to use if you see some differences like that. So remember, staying on top of sulfur deficiency is really important. We really improve alfalfa yield, and a good way to assess whether you need sulfur is through a tissue test. Soil sampling is not necessarily the best practice for sulfur, but tissue sampling in alfalfa is a really good tool.